this video I will go through parking signs in Australia. Green parking sign means you are allowed to park. Red parking sign means you are not allowed to park. So as you can see, this is the first sign we are going to see. 1P. 1 means 1 hour. P means parking. You can do 1 hour parking, and that too from Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Outside of these hours you can park for unlimited hours, but if you want to park between Monday to Friday between 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. you will have to park only for 1 hour. If you exceed the limit, you will get a ticket or parking fine. Next symbol is this one. This is a no stopping sign, which means you are not supposed to stop in that section of the road where this symbol or sign is installed. So here they have given the timings 7 to 9 a.m. and then 2 to 4 p.m. and the school days. So that means during school days you can't stop in that particular section of the road and for that timings. Then over here you can see that these two signs are combined, no stopping sign and 2P sign. So what it means is that you can't stop between 4 to 6 p.m. and from Monday to Friday, but you can park for 2 hours from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. from Monday to Friday. So from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. you can park there for 2 hours. So there is a limit of 2 hours. The next important sign is clear way. Clear way sign means you can't stop in this section of the road, and if you park your vehicle over there in that clear way section, your vehicle may be towed, and once your vehicle is towed, you will have to pay hefty fine like $500-$600. That is huge amount. Then no stopping sign, we have already seen this. Yellow no stopping lines. Yellow line means you are not supposed to stop in that section of the road. No parking sign. This sign means that you are not supposed to park in that section of the road at any time or any day. Parking near intersections. If you want to park your vehicle near intersections, there are two types in that: signalized and unsignalized. Signalized means the intersection where there are traffic lights. Unsignalized means intersection where there are no traffic lights. So if you want to park your vehicle near signalized intersection, then as you can see in this figure or image, you have to keep 20 meters of distance towards a signal and then 3 meters of distance towards the right side of your car. And at unsignalized intersection, you can see that there is a limit of 10 meter. Parking near bus stop. You can't park very close to bus stop. You have to keep safe distance, that is 20 meter of the approach to the bus stop sign and 10 meters of the departure side of the stop sign. That's how you can park near bus stop. There can be two types of specialized lanes: bus lane and transit lane. In bus lane, only buses, taxis, bicycles are allowed. Motorcycle is not allowed. Motorcycles are not allowed, and you are not supposed to park in the bus lane or transit lanes. In the transit lanes, these buses, taxis, bicycles, motorcycles are allowed, and you are supposed to drive in the transit lane. Like if the transit lane is marked as T2, that means that you can drive in that lane only if there are two or more passengers in your car. Then footpaths and crossings. As you can see, you can do the street parking, but make sure that you are not parking your car right in front of walkways, pathways. As you can see, all the cars that are marked in red color, that is incorrect or invalid parking. You might get fined if you park your car like that. Also remember that you are not supposed to park your car in the disabled parking slot. Only if you have got disabled permit, then only you can park your car over there. Now let us see what is permit parking areas. There can be two types of control areas: traffic and parking control areas, and resident permit parking schemes. Main purpose of this traffic areas or the parking control areas and resident permit parking areas is that residents or people who are living near hospitals or major places near city should be able to park their vehicles on the streets. What happens is that if you want to go to hospital, most of the people will try to get to the nearest suburb and park their car, which can cause problems to the people who are actually living in that suburb. So to prevent these things, they have created this Brisbane traffic areas or parking control areas and resident permit parking areas like that. In the first line, they are saying that Brisbane Central is one area and the scheme type is traffic area. That means only 2 hours of parking is allowed, and during these times, Monday to Friday, 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Then if you go down here, you can see that for hospitals, they have created some parking areas. For Auchenflower Wesley Hospital, they have got resident parking permit parking area from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. daily. It means that you can park in that area, but only for 2 hours, not more than that. If you have got the resident permit, then you can park unlimited time. But if you don't have the resident permit, then you have to park there only for 2 hours. And similarly, they have created various areas depending upon the importance of the location. For example, this Gabba, this cricket stadium, they have got a traffic area over there as well, because there is a lot of traffic during matches, like cricket matches or any other kinds of matches. So here you can see that in this sign, resident permit parking area, there is a limit of 2 hours from Monday to Friday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. But you can see down there, resident permit accepted. That means this particular limit applies to only people who don't have a resident permit. If you have got a resident permit, then you can park for unlimited hours. In some part of city, you can do paid parking, like there are some parking meters, or you can also pay using one app called as Selo Park. There is something called as loading zones as well. Loading zone is nothing but if you want to pick up or drop off the passengers, or if you want to load goods into your vehicle, then in that particular scenario you can use the loading zones. And there are some limits, like in this first sign you can see that if you are loading the passengers, then only you can wait there for 2 minutes. If you are loading goods, then you can wait for up to 20 minutes for non-commercial vehicles. If your vehicle is commercial vehicle, you can wait there for 30 minutes. Then in the second symbol you can see that there is loading zone passengers 2 minutes max. That means only passengers loading is allowed over there, and that too for 2 minutes only you can wait. Goods loading is not allowed when this symbol is there or sign is there. Then loading zone commercial vehicles 20 minutes max. So here you can see that passenger loading is not allowed, then goods loading is not allowed for non-commercial vehicles, and goods loading is allowed for commercial vehicles but for only 20 minutes. And finally, and they have given their passengers 2 minutes max and commercial vehicle 20 minutes max. So nothing is mentioned, this first column will apply. Then there are some special use zones, like bus zone, taxi zone, work zone. Bus zone means that only buses are allowed in that particular section of the road. Then taxi zone means only taxis are allowed. Work zone means vehicle is used for nearby construction work are permitted to stop in work zone. Then mail zone means postal vehicles are permitted to stop in this area. And already I told you this disability parking. That means that only if you have got disability permit, you can park in that particular, near that particular sign. Here they have given the map of traffic and parking control areas and resident permit parking areas in Brisbane, along with this limits. Like Brisbane Central traffic area, there is a limit of 2 hours. You have to follow all the signs that are there. If you do not follow signs, then you might get a ticket or fine, and you have to pay this fine. If you do not pay, then your vehicle may be towed or your license may be cancelled. If you have more questions related to parking, let me know through the comments. Thanks for watching this video.